four off the block. I'm Vinny Lopes. I am now joined by Sunil Thomas, the first-year starting setter for Ohio State, but he has been anything but playing like a first-year setter this year, folks, leading the nation in assists per game average, and he has now helped the Buckeyes advance to the Volley Four as they'll be taking on Long Beach State on Thursday night. And I got to ask you, let's talk about this match against the 49ers. What are you expecting?
I mean, we're expecting a lot, honestly. There, you know that they're a really, really good team. I mean, one loss throughout the whole season is very, very tough to do. So you know that they're pretty good. So we're just expecting, a challenge tomorrow night, and we're just trying to give it our best and see what happens.
Now, in watching them on film, or you know, what has been the thing that stood out for you most about them that makes Long Beach State so difficult?
I think what makes them so good, one, is how fast their offense is, especially to the pins. I mean, they run really, really quickly, so it's really, really hard for Tech to close on that block with the middles, especially if their in-system is going to be pretty impossible, I'd say, if they're in-system and they're running as fast as they do. And second is their defense. I mean, they get so many different touches or digs, just, you know, it's kind of just being in the right area and kind of just putting their hands out and just getting some random touches out, that can honestly really be, you know, demeaning for or deteriorating for a team and their confidence and stuff. But that's just something that we have to, you know, play through and, you know, just get back, because we know that they're a great team. They're going to make some great kills, make some great plays. So we can't let it affect us too much and just, you know, bounce back.
Now I want to ask you, because, you know, you've been a part of this team, but, you know, you were part of that NCAA championship team last year. This was your first real chance to get in the starting lineup and in your win, or this season, and you had a great performance in the win against UC Irvine last night in the first round match. I just want to ask you, what was that experience like for you being on the court last night going up against the Anteaters?
Honestly, it was really fun. I mean, like you said, first time starting and, you know, being under the bright lights, playing against a team like Irvine, who, you know, played really well and played, you know, gave it their all and gave it their best. You know, it was really, really fun to compete against them and just, you know, just grind it out against them, because it was a really, really tight match, a really fun match for whoever was watching. And even being a part of it, it was awesome just to see how, you know, the momentum switches and all that kind of stuff. So it was great to just be a part of it all. And I'm just fortunate enough to have the teammates that I do to make me look, you know, better than I actually am. And you know, I can set a guy like, you know, Nicholas Zerzan and he'll put the ball away no matter where it really is. So that's also comforting and beneficial to me. So, I mean, it was just really fun to be a part of this whole thing.
Yeah, well, and I want to ask you about that. When you have a player like Nick on the outside, for you as a setter, how difficult is it sometimes to make sure that you're not just saying to him and that you're running a balanced offense?
I mean, it gets hard at times, especially when, you know, in those tight situations and in crunch time, when you have a guy like Nick, everything tells you, all instinct tells you to give the ball to him, and even sometimes the other team knows that too, and sometimes you can do it, and even if they're, you know, they're two blocks in front of him, he still find a way to, you know, put the ball away. But yeah, you can't just ride his coattails forever, because, you know, he'll probably get tired if you get setting him like 50 balls or something like that. So that's when you know you have to have a balanced offense and have other people help out because he can't do it all himself. As great as he is, he can't do it all himself. We just got to help him any way that we can. And so it's tough, but I try and find a way the best I can.
Yeah. Well, talking about you, like we've mentioned, this was your first year staying. Our first year as a starting setter, obviously, I've been staying for a very long time. But what do you feel this year? What have you learned about yourself kind of in that starting lineup and really going through the full grind of the season playing every match?
Honestly, I've been trying to learn match by match, how to approach the game and learn from, you know, what works and what doesn't work and decision making and stuff like that. I learned that, you know, what's best for me and as a team is, you know, having confidence in yourself and believing that, you know, you've worked so hard so far that there's nothing to be nervous and nothing to be scared about, but just play your game. You know, this is my first year starting, but, you know, I've been doing this for a good amount of time, and I have guys backing me up that give me confidence and coaches that give me confidence and, you know, all that they have trust in me, so that makes the job a lot a lot easier. You know, I just try to do the best I can to put my teammates in the best situation that they can be in. And I think that's the recipe that works for success.
Well, I want to ask you as well about one player as well who's new to the starting lineup, and that's Jay Kane. Don, can you talk a little bit about, you know, what's that connection that you guys have? You feel that that's been an improvement that you've made throughout the season, especially just, you know, when you see the numbers they put up last night?
Yeah, I think, I mean, Jay Kane's been playing really, really well, especially as a player, especially in the match yesterday. He played amazing, lights out. You know, in the beginning of the year, it was definitely a little tough finding that rhythm with him. But I think over the year, even match by match, I think it's progressively getting better and better, which is huge because, you know, if you have a guy on the back end to balance out our, you know, strength on the left end, that keeps the middle blockers honest, keeps them in the middle, especially if Jay can do things that he has been doing. And he's shown a lot of growth, shown a lot of, you know, mental toughness, especially in the tough situations in clutch time. And he's, you know, he's always risen to the occasion. And I think that our connection is actually pretty good. I think it obviously could definitely be better, I'd say, but I mean, I think it's working well for us.
And two final questions before we let you go. For you, you look at this match against Long Beach today. I think a lot of people are viewing you as the underdog. But yeah. What do you feel is the one or two big things that you guys are going to have to do well on Thursday night to get the win?
I think one is, I mean, as from a technical standpoint, is, you know, do what we've done the past 3 years and what has got us to national championships, which is serve the ball tough and serve the ball in and force them to make plays. You know, I think if we have consistent service pressure throughout the whole match, it might not guarantee a win, but it's going to be our best chance to get a win, that's for sure. And I think second is always respond well, you know, because, you know, like I said before, they're a great team. They're going to make great plays. They're going to make some unreal plays, and you just can't let it demoralize us or bring us down, but we just got to answer, you know, bounce back, get a quick side out and stuff like that. So it's just responding well to what, you know, they're a good team, so they're going to have big plays. So I think it's just how we answer, how we respond.
All right, and one final question, a little bit of a lighter note. Obviously, the primary focus of you guys being out there is to play volleyball, get a three-peat, but non-volleyball related, what's been the most fun thing you guys have done since you've been out in L.A.?
Actually, I think it was last night. No, two nights ago, we went to this Italian restaurant on, what is it, Marina Del Rey. And it was an awesome restaurant, super nice, and the view was awesome the whole time. We got to just, you know, venture out a little bit, just, you know, walk around a bit. And it was just really fun. It was a nice time for, you know, camaraderie, team bonding, all that kind of stuff. I just wish the weather in L.A. was better. You know, in Columbus right now, I think it's like 80, and here it's like gray and 55 or 60. So that's kind of annoying, I guess. But, I mean, we're here for volleyball, and so we're just kind of, you know, focused on that and, you know, keep pushing and see how far the season goes.
All right. You got follow-up because you brought up Italian food. What did you order at the restaurant?
Oh, I can't even pronounce it, honestly. It was Pollo al Italiano. I have no idea.
Was it good, though? That's the most important
thing. Yeah, it was delicious. It was delicious, that's for sure.